We've all heard the saying that TV is dead.
What? The fist job is all I have!
But that's an overreaction.
And a simplification. I mean, people have been saying the same thing about radio for years.
This sepia tone job is all I have!
It's time to face facts. The buggers lied to you, and I'm going to stop with this voice.
Video didn't kill the radio star. In fact, it just made it slightly less relevant than it was before, but still totally relevant. Just ask Southern Cross Austereo. When Kyle and Jackie O left the station in Sydney, the network lost $100 million from their market capitalisation. Trust me, the radio star and the video star, very much alive.
So I'm fine.
Yes, yeah. Jan from two time periods. Kinda?
Let me explain. We might not necessarily sit around the wireless as a family anymore, but we do still listen to the radio, mainly just to fuel our casual racism.
Muslims across the world, we remember how they behaved following the slaughter of 9/11, celebrating and dancing in the streets.
Muslims are the worst. You weren't filming that, were you?
It's the same way with broadcast TV, although to a lesser extent with the racism since we lost the Bolt Report. Never forget. The thing that has changed is that increasingly we want to watch our shows at our convenience, so instead of tuning in, we watch on demand. Really, the only person who's sticking to the schedule is New South Wales Premier Mike Baird's social media manager tweeting The Bachelor to try and seem hip. Now, people love to pull out figures like Netflix in Australia has jumped from 200,000 accounts in the last year to over a million, Stan has 700,000 accounts, and Presto has who gives a f**k, it's Presto. All in an effort to prove the death of television.
What it actually shows is the death of free-to-air television, which is something we've been enjoying for over 60 years. Unless you're a cashed-up bogan with a Foxtel account.
Oh, shit! Diagnosis murder, that's my jam!
People love to predict the demise of media, and they've been doing so for decades. When video recorders launched, you know, they thought that cinema was going to die, and that was the big prediction at the time. But of course, cinema grew and grew, and who records with a video recorder anymore?
These guys. But we do get your point. What is scary for free-to-air TV is that 1 in 7 Australians no longer watch it.
I think that may have been the case for quite some years, that 1 in 7 are not watching free-to-air television, and younger demographics maybe more so.
That statistic was actually released last month and shows that in the last 8 years, the number of Australians not watching free-to-air TV has doubled. So how can the networks keep those numbers from getting even larger?
Interesting, like the future of free-to-air networks is kind of based on the past. When TV first started, it was all about live, and that's what we're going to probably head back to. Live programming, live panels, live shows, stuff that will actually draw the viewer in because you can't watch it anywhere else because that's where it exists. And so as the audience keeps splintering down into more and more different channels, podcasts, streaming, torrents, anything really, there's going to be less audience for television networks to make their money on. So their profits will shrink, the scale of their production will shrink down to just panel shows and people who are on TV interviewing other people who used to be on TV about the future of television.
Basically, free-to-air TV is like the CD of the content world. Sure, it will stick around until the last Gen Xer gets a Netflix account or dies. Then we'll just have a series of accounts to watch whichever future space shows exist by then, which ultimately will be more expensive but far more tailored to our personal tastes.